So today we will discuss about the various type of renewable energy resources. In the previous session, we have discussed about the basic of renewable energy resources. Renewable energy resources, that is the resources which we can use again and again. These are non-exhaustible. These type of resources will not affect the environment. They will not create any type of pollution. So the renewable energy resources are very much in demand in coming years, and there are different type of renewable energy resources like solar energy, biomass energy, geothermal energy, wind energy, tidal waves energy, etc. And the non-renewable energy resources are like oil, petrol, coal, etc. And these are the resources which are limited, and they are polluting the environment, and they are exhaustible in nature. So first we will discuss about solar energy. Solar energy is most important form of renewable energy, and most of the renewable energy are depend upon the solar energy. Like when we are talking about wind energy, so how wind is produced? So wind is depend upon the solar system, because when the solar radiations fall on the surface of the earth, the heat, the air which is close to the earth get heated up, and this heated air will move in upward direction and replaced by the cold air. Similarly the air which is present close to the surface of the water is heated. But what happen, the heating process or the air which is close to the surface of the earth heated very rapidly than the air which is close to the surface of the water. Therefore a flow of current of wave of air is there, and therefore a pressure difference is created and wind is generated, and that wind is responsible to rotate the part, or the we can say the blades of the turbine, and therefore electricity is produced through the generator. Similarly the biomass energy is also depend upon the solar energy, because biomass energy, the energy which is obtained from wood, and these wood is obtained from the plants or some forest areas, and the growth of the plant and the forest is depend upon the solar system, because some photosynthesis process is there for the growth of the plant, and that is happened only because when solar energy is there. So these energy, similarly tidal wave energy is also depend upon the solar system, because there is a solar effect, or the water which is in the close to the solar system, means in the direction of solar system, having some gravitational force, and the water which is opposite to the solar system having some different force that is created by the earth, and therefore a different tides or different waves are generated that are called tides. And these energy we can utilize for some commercial purposes. So solar energy is very, very important. Now solar energy is clean and abundantly available renewable energy resources. Now we know that there are basically three modes of energy transfer, and these are conduction, convection and radiation. So radiation is the major, we can say, mode that is used to transfer the energy, heat energy of solar system to different purposes, to heat the air which is close to the earth, to heat the building, to heat the water which is contained in a solar pond, in the solar pond, the radiation which is passed through the water get absorbed at the bottom of the surface of the solar pond, and there is a brine solution is there that will heat it up, and that will store the energy in the form of heat. That heat we can use to convert the water into steam, and that steam is used to in a steam turbine for producing of electricity. So solar energy, we are using radiation. It is a clean type of energy. There is no pollution. The total radiant energy of the sun is vast, out of which only small fraction gets incident on the outside of the earth atmosphere. That is 30% of it is directly reflected back to the outer space in the short wave radiation. Means 30% is reflected back. 47% is directly converted to heat that is lost to the outer space in the long wave radiation, and major portion of the rest 23% causes evaporation, precipitation and circulation of water in the hydrologic cycle of the earth. Means this energy is used to heat the water, and then water is get vaporized in the atmosphere. Then cloudy areas, clouds are there, that clouds again convert water into that steam evaporated form into liquid form, and that liquid or water gets is used in for different purposes, like for the growth of the plant, water is required. For the life of the human being, water is required. So this causes evaporation, precipitation and circulation of water in the hydrologic cycle of the earth. Sun radiates its energy in all directions of the universe. Means in all directions energy is radiated. Sun is assumed to be a spherical body. So in all direction x, y, z, we can say the energy is radiated. Sunlight received during day hours and clear sky has power density between 0.5 kilowatt per meter square and 1 kilowatt per meter square. Solar energy varies with season, geographical location, day night, etc. Means in cold season the direction will change, therefore the energy received from the sun is different. Similarly, geographical location means hill area having different amount of energy, plain area having different amount of energy. In coldest area, like in American countries, there is a different amount of energy. In India, there is a different. And in day, solar energy is maximum, while in night, it is almost zero. So, solar energy depend upon the or varies with season, geographical location, day, night, etc. Now, there are certain merits, or we can say advantage of solar energy. Merits and some demerits also. Now first is the noiseless operation. Noiseless operation because there are no rotational or movable part we are using when we are utilizing this type of energy. Occupies less space on floor as there is no need of storage vessels, because there is no requirement of storing this energy as a storage vessel. So less space is required. What we are doing, we are using the mirrors. That mirror is takes the radiations and reflect it back at the focal point, and that focal point is basically the concentrating point, and at that point a fluid is there that is heated up, and that heat of the that heated fluid is used to convert the water into steam. Then cheaper initial cost and no need of containers to store the fuels. Means we are not using any fuels for producing the energy. So it is cheaper initial cost and no containers required. Like in petrol, we need some container, we need some spaces there. Similarly, diesel, kerosene, all these things, we need some containers. In most of the equipment, the maintenance cost is negligible. Means like we are using the different type of collectors. Collectors may be different types, like focusing. And non. So collectors are of two types, focusing and non-focusing. So in these collectors, like we are using flat plate collectors or some parabolic type of collectors. So what is happen? These collectors will collect the heat or accept the radiations and transfer this radiation at the focal point, and that is used to convert the that used to heat the fluid flowing through this concentrator, and that heated fluid is used to convert the water into steam. So maintenance cost is negligible. There is no rotating parts, or means the cost is very less. In most of the equipment do not require any serious attention during real working. For example, food will be cooked simply by putting a solar cooker in sunlight. You can simply put place a solar cooker in that air, and radiations falls over the surface of the solar cooker, and that is used to cook the food. Now there are certain demerits also. Solar equipments fail to work in nights, cloudy day or rainy season. As we know that solar energy is not continuous in nature. In nights or some cloudy days or in rainy season, and solar energy is not available. So in that case, in that stage, solar equipments will not work. And second is, large space is required for the collection of solar energy at a useful rate. Now tidal energy. Tidal energy, it is a second type of renewable energy, we can say. So tidal power exploits the movement of water caused by the tidal currents or the rise and fall in the sea levels due to the tides. So tides are basically the generated, or the waves are generated because of the effect of the gravitational force of sun and moon. So sun, solar effect and lunar effect. So maximum effect is created by the lunar. So solar effect is 30% and the lunar effect is maximum, that is 70%. So what happened? The water which is in front of the solar system or solar or in the moon having a gravitational force, and the water which is in the side of the earth having a gravitational force by the earth. So because of these different gravitational forces, the tides are generated, and that tides will use to generate the electricity for some commercial purposes. Although not yet widely used, it has potential for future electricity generation and is more predictable than wind energy and solar power. Means the direction of solar and lunar is changes, and we need some suitable areas where we can produce such type of energy. There should not be a disturbance created by the some navigation. So it is very less in amount in comparison to the other type of renewable energy. The technology required to harness tidal energy is well established. However, it remains expensive and there are relatively few applications, around 40 worldwide. Then ocean tides are produced by gravitational forces of sun and moon. There are only a few sites in the world where tidal energy can be suitably harnessed. In India, it is not there. Still, no source of energy of this type of tidal is available. The Bay of Fundy, Canada, having 17-18 meter high tides, has a potential of 5000 megawatt of power generation. Now, one more thing is this is the tidal energy, and second is the ocean energy. So there is a difference between tidal energy and ocean energy. That is ocean thermal energy conversion. We can say that ocean thermal energy, in ocean thermal energy, what is there? There are sources there and sink is there. Means source, that is the surface of the water of the ocean having the higher temperature than the water which is lying below the sea, which is at lesser temperature, and because of this temperature difference, that energy is utilized for some commercial work or some useful work, we can say. Ocean tides are produced by in India, Gulf of Cambay, Gulf of Kutch and the Sundarban Delta are the tidal power sites, but they are not much effective. Now, there are certain merits and demerits of this type of energy also. Merits are very less area is required because they are on base. It is free from pollution as it does not use any fuel. Only water is there, and their variation of flow of high and low is responsible for conversion of energy. It is much superior to hydropower plant as it is totally depend of a drain which always fluctuates year to year. It does not produce any unhealthy waste like gases, ash, etc. because we are not using any fuel or some combustion element. Therefore, no type of gases like in geothermal energy. What is there? In geothermal energy, most of the gases are harmful and they are produced and they will create harmful effect to the environment. Similarly, we are not using coal or some other type of fuel. So, there is no ash is there. Tidal power has unique capacity to meet the peak power demand effectively when it works in combination with thermal and hydro system. So when we are using in combination with thermal and hydro system, both type of system is utilized and tidal power is very much effective. Now there are certain disadvantage of this type of energy. Tidal power plants can be developed only if natural sites are available. Means only natural sites are available, then only we can produce. We cannot create if we create a dam like that for utilizing some energy of potential energy of water to convert into kinetic energy using a penstock, and that kinetic energy is used to run the blade of the turbine. But in case of tidal power, we cannot create such type of things, not in a large scale. So this is a major disadvantage of tidal power. As the sites are available on the bay, which will be always far away from the load center. So where actual load is transferred is we have to use the energy in actual form. These are very, very far away from the source. So the power generated involves more transmission cost. Transmission cost is more, and also some wastage of energy is there. Supply of power depends upon the timing of tides. Definitely, if timing of tides, only when tides are there, only then power is produced, hence not continuous. To solve this problem, double basin with pump storage must be made. So additional cost is there. The capital cost of the plant is high. And the navigation is obstructed, means navigation movement of ships are also obstructed when such type of energy is used or to generate some energy using tidal waves. Next is the MSD energy, that is magneto hydrodynamic power generation. So the MSD generation, or also known as magneto hydrodynamic power generation, is a direct energy conversion system which converts the heat energy directly into electrical energy without any intermediate mechanical energy conversion, as opposed to the case in all other power generating plants. What happens in this type of energy, we are using a source of hot electrically conducting gas. This gas we are using instead of, like in conventional energy system, we are using a solid conductor. So we are using hot electrically conducting gas, this gas is moving with certain velocity, v, in this direction. This is the direction of motion of the gas. Now, perpendicular to this, we are placing magnets. This north and south magnets are there. These are basically magnets. So, as we know that when a conducting gas or conductor is moving with certain velocity and a magnetic field is created perpendicular to the conductor, perpendicular to the direction of the moving of conductor, a EMF is induced along the electrodes. These are the electrodes. So, a EMF is induced and that is used to convert or used to convert some form of energy. That is here we are using or we are running a bulb for the demonstration purpose here. So, this is a magnetohydrodynamic energy, and there are also, these are of two types. That is, we are using the closed type of system and open type of energy system. Now, there are certain merits of this MLG system. More reliable since there are no moving parts, because there are no moving parts, only gas is moving with certain velocity, but there is no hardware component that is moving. So, it is more reliable. In MSD systems, the efficiency can be about 50% as compared to less than 40% for most efficient steam plant. So, most efficient steam plant, we are using water and then convert into steam. That steam is also corrode the blades of that turbine. So, overall efficiency is less. As soon as it is started, it can reach the full power level. Means, as soon as the process is started, it is immediately reach the maximum power level that is used to for commercial or industrial purposes. But in other type of energy system, it is not so. Power produced is free from pollution, less overall operating cost. The capital cost of MSD plants is comparable to those of conventional steam plant. There are certain demerits of this type of energy. MSD system suffers from the reverse flow, short circuits of the electrons through the conducting fluids around the end of the magnetic field. Means the gases which are moving in the side region of that magnetic field, there is a chance of the reverse flow and short circuit of reverse flow of the electron and short circuiting is there. There will be high friction losses and heat transfer losses because gas is moving with certain velocity over the and the magnets are placed perpendicular to it. There is a direct contact between the gas and the magnet, and there is a friction losses is there and also heat transfer losses there. The friction loss may be as high as 12% of the input. Next is the fuel cell. A fuel cell, it is also a renewable energy resources. A fuel cell is an electrochemical cell that converts the chemical energy of fuel of a hydrogen and an oxidizing agent of an oxygen into electricity through a pair of redox reactions. What happens when hydrogen we are using? It converts hydrogen plus 2 into hydrogen ion. So, hydrogen ion, so electrons are released, hydrogen is converted into 2 electrons and hydrogen positive ion, and these electrons are moving in the external region from one electrode to another electrode, and therefore electricity is generated at the external load. We can utilize that means energy in some commercial purposes, and these electrons reaches to the another second electrode that react with the oxygen and makes the OH hydroxyl ion. Means oxygen plus electrons and convert into OH ion. And these OH and hydrogen means here 2 hydrogen plus OH ion convert into water. So water is convert into water. So this is a fuel cell and energy. Fuel cells are different from most batteries in requiring a continuous source of fuel and oxygen to sustain the chemical reaction, whereas in battery the chemical energy usually comes from the metals. Fuel cells can produce electricity continuously for as long as fuel and oxygen are supplied. So this is about the fuel cell energy. So this is total to about the different type of renewable energy resources. In the next class we will discuss these some more renewable energy resources in detail. Thank you.